This video is brought to you by Miniature Market. Thousands of board games, discounted prices, miniaturemarket.com. Hello my friends, it's the Game Boy Geek here. Today it's time to get tricky once again with some wordplay, trying to figure out what words to use to try to get your partner to guess it. Now, about a month ago I went to the Gamma Trade Show in Las Vegas. It's an industry-only event, and I got a chance to get a sneak peek at Codenames Duet, a two-player specific only designed game by Czech's Game Edition, a follow-up, a sequel to the other versions of Codenames that are out there. And I thought I'd do a sneak, since I got a chance to play a full game, I thought I'd do sort of a sneak peek and a mini review. I'm calling these sort of preludes, as I'm getting most of the series on my channel is sort of musically based, since I'm also a musician. A prelude is music, and it's also a prelude to the main review that will come when the game finally comes out. But I'm going to give you a mini review, just an idea of how the game works, a quick one, and it's because there's not a lot of information about this out there yet, so here we go. Now, Codenames Duet is this two-player version that's played very similarly to the original version. There's a 5x5 grid of different words. There'll be some new cards for this, but each of you sit on the other side of the table from each other, and you're both clue givers. You're going to give pretty much a one-word clue, just like normal Codenames, and the other player is trying to guess which ones they are. Now, you're both using the same colored tiles, unlike the regular version, because you're on the same team. You're working cooperatively together, and you have those green tiles that you're going to be putting on the correct answers. Now, the cool thing about this is that the card is double-sided, so one player will see something like this, and you'll see the nine green squares, and those are the words on that you're looking at that you have to get them to guess. There's nine total clues. There's also an assassin. But when we flip that card over, or if you're looking at it from the other way like the other person would be, you'll see basically there's nine again, but there's a different assassin. And the cool thing is there's three of these clues that are actually in the same spot as the other player's clues. So there's nine total clues, but three of them are actually the same. They're shared words there, and that gives a game a really interesting twist. Now, giving clues, when I played it, you can give clues multiple times in a row, and then the other player can chime in when they feel they're ready. But I hear that they've actually changed that now, where you have to alternate. I hope they make that a variant that you can do it the other way in free form. Now, if you guess something wrong, you'll be putting the sort of the neutral spy thing on the word. And then if you get your fourth one, the game ends and you lose. You're trying to get through all of the tiles before the end of the round. And essentially each round that you play, you put a tile in front of you. And if you have not been able to place all those tiles by the time you've run out, well, the game's over. So there's both a clock that you're running against, or the number of clues you're running against, and there is the spies that you're running against, the neutral ones, and of course, the assassin. So it plays similar, but there's definitely a lot of twists, and definitely designed just for two players. All right, well, there you have it. So again, I've only played the game once. It was a full time, and then I watched another game be played. And so what did I like about it? Well, I know that they're going to be coming with a whole new set of cards, which is always great. Having new cards, new words, always great if you play a lot of Codenames. And obviously, as I mentioned, it's obviously designed for two players. Now, why is this needed? You say, hey, the regular game did have a variant for the two player. It did, and it worked okay. I actually really liked the idea that you had to, as you're giving clues, you had to cover up words, and you get to pick which one to cover up in the original game. But then again, at the end, it was just a score of whether you did it or not, and you know, oh, well, how good did you do? Where this one is like, you either win or you lose. And so it puts a little bit more pressure, makes it more of a game. But in addition to that, you still have many of the things that make Codename what it is. You still have that sort of internal clock where you're only going to get a certain amount of guesses in this case to get it. Usually you're going against another person, but in this case, you have a certain amount of rounds to be able to get all of the words on each side to get there. And that brings me to probably the coolest thing, is that card that has, it's double-sided, and each of you have nine clues that you got to get done, but three of them are shared. And that's really the coolest twist here, is because as they're giving you clues, you're like, I think it's this one, but now I'm even might be more sure, because that's one of the clues I gotta give them. We haven't guessed any of our words yet, and so it just gives a nice twist and a nice arc to the game, as if those clues are already taken, then you're gonna really think, oh, is that it? We've already used all our three clues, or sometimes you don't really know if they're, which you know, if you've already done all three, it just gives a really good intrigue to the game. It gives a nice little twist to it. It's still hard because, you know, if you guess wrong enough times, I think on the fourth time that you guess one of those neutral ones, game's over. So you could lose by time, you could lose by guessing too many incorrects, you could also lose by guessing those assassins like normal. Now, when I played the game, there was just, each of us had an assassin, but they were in different spots. And I've already talked to them, I've talked to them recently, they've already been developing the game further since I played it. And I hear that they're playing with ideas with even more than one assassin on each side. And maybe it's variants, maybe that's the way it's gonna be. Also, one of the cool things was, I really liked the idea that while I was playing it, you could you didn't have to alternate clues. You could actually, hey, you know, if I'm an experienced player, my wife's not, she normally would never be a clue giver in a normal Codenames game, because it's just so thinky, especially right at the beginning when there's so much to think about. Well, you know what, if I'm a gamer and she's not, I could give the first two or three clues, start narrowing the board down, which then gives it a little bit easier for her because there's not as much really to stare at. And I really like that aspect, but I've heard that they've changed the rules since I've played this, that you're forced to alternate. I heard they did this because it stops one person from taking over. But I hope they at least put this in as a variant. If you're playing with an inexperienced player, we recommend playing with this variant where you don't have to alternate. And quite honestly, if they don't put in the rules, I'm going to be playing that way pretty much anyways because I loved it. Maybe if I'm playing with two experienced players, I'll play, you know, the other way. But I liked the idea. I really thought that was such a great thing that you're not forced to alternate. So I hope they change that, or at least, you know, put the variant in there, because I hear that they've taken that away. But overall, I was really impressed. It just felt right. It felt, you know, it's almost like when you played Seven Wonders and you played it two-player and you're like, this isn't very good. And then you played a Seven Wonders duel and you're like, wow, designed for two players, this is great. Same thing here. The first one was like, okay, it's all right. But now it's like, wow, this is so cool. I love Codenames, and to bring it into another sort of aspect, another different way of playing it. I mean, it is Codenames after all. And it does feel like Codenames. But it still feels like a different game because of those things that I've just mentioned. So I'm really interested to play this some more. Interested to see what they do developing further. Again, they're toying around with some other ideas still, so it's not even final. But even the one that I played, wow, I love it. So if you like Codenames, and if you're at all going to be playing with two players, this is kind of a no-brainer insta-buy. And I'm really looking forward to playing this more, but huge thumbs up. And actually, this made my top 10 most anticipated games of the year because I played it and I was so captivated by it. Of course, Codenames I love anyway. So if you haven't seen that top 10 video, I'll put a link in the description here and you can check that out. But Codenames Duet, great thumbs up for me.
This video was sponsored by Miniature Market's Review Corner. The Review Corner features podcasts, video, and written game reviews by gamers for gamers. Miniature Market, the online gaming superstore. Thousands of board games, discounted prices. Check them out at miniaturemarket.com.